Guys, this is Praveen. I think the whole world knows Praveen and Mehak.
I'm so glad to be here, Lizella. First of all, thank you so much for giving us the opportunity to be a part of the fitness because I'm nothing else about it. I think close to 10 years.
Yeah, 10 to 12 years.
10 years ago, we were talking to
each other. Yeah.
10 to 12 years.
Easily.
See, Lizella, I keep getting, I'm sure that you must have got to understand people talking about your transformation and the way you inspire other people. I do get a lot of messages saying that, especially that hashtag that we have of this, it did really wonders. Your transformation, it inspired a lot of people to take a step, to get fit, to feel good kind of stuff. So which is commendable. And you proved that, you know, I've trained you for like so many years in the past.
Yeah.
That one sudden day you decided that I'm going to make a change. No, I'm very serious about it. And you took it so seriously. And, you know, it's unbelievable when you post those stories on the Instagram saying that, मैंने ये बनाया but you don't touch anything out of it and you stick to that which is really commendable. Yeah. I have like humongous amount of respect for you that. So keep it up, guys. So today, Lizella, you want to definitely ask all those questions.
Yeah, and why is it
there are a lot of ways that you can do a tummy tuck and a number of things, but Lizella's transformation is literally hard work.
You know, guys, there's a joke between Praveen and me. Like, I know Praveen. I mean, I have so many times joined Praveen's training and then midway I have disappeared. And right. Then Remo has continued and Remo has gone away to make his body. I remember one day in somewhere December 2018 that I messaged Praveen that, you know.
Yeah.
No, he
Instagram.
Yeah. He posted something about some weight thing and I said, listen, you must be the world's best trainer.
Yeah.
You don't see a white thing. There's a black dot on it. You see the black dot.
Yeah.
So you are the black dot.
Die, still remember those words.
Yeah. I always used to tell Praveen one thing. I said, Praveen, safed paper pe kya dikhta hai? If I put a black dot, what can you see? So he used to say black dot. I said, see, remember, I'm your black dot. Till I don't lose weight, you forget.
Yeah, you are the public, whatever that you are, doesn't make sense of. Doesn't make value. And I'm so glad that today I'm sitting with you and, you know, so proud to say that, you know, that black dot is not anymore.
You know, honestly, if it was not for Praveen and Mehak and always pushing, and I used to get so irritated on times that I used to say, bas ho gaya. Then he says, acha, wait, I'll change your diet. And then, you know, he changed my workout, which Praveen knows I hate cardio.
Yeah.
So slowly, he started, you know, putting stuff where, you know, till today he fires me for cardio, which I hate doing.
Still see like Lizelle messaging him saying that, okay, I'm going, this is the second time I'm going for my workout. And I used to be like so surprised. I used to tell Praveen, I'm like hats off, and I'm like so happy that going one time was okay, let's plan, let's train today. But then for her, coming from her and saying that I'm doing 2-time workout and maintaining that discipline and consistency was commendable.
Basically, when I started off with Praveen, I was 104. Right, Praveen?
Yeah, that's right.
I think 104 or 105. It was a fluctuation. There was times I think we went to even 106, 107. And I used to be like, oh, bloody hell. It was like unbelievable what was happening. Because I don't know whether it is what. And today, as I talk, I am fluctuating between 66 and 67.
40
kilos. Yeah, almost 40 kilos. And I think another target of ours is another 6 kilos.
Yeah.
No off days, always.
No off days, exactly. No off days. Except that also, you can always stay with us to, you know, give that little extra push. Yeah. Especially when Lizelle used to take breaks in between the sets, you always came up there.
Yeah.
Said something, and what you said, sometimes you give her a hug. And said something, and you know, all those things really helped us to push that extra mile in the training.
Yes.
And you know, that I still remember those days that when the new rack came in the gym, in the Obrey's gym, and when she did some new movement squat clean, did some nice squats, you were always there to push us, you know, to give her the compliments that that and that that compliment part, it makes a huge difference, you know, in that mindset. So we'll be asking Lisiel, exactly what is in your mind? How did you do this transmission? Like, so even I am surprised, to be very frank, even I don't know what played such a foodie woman, you know.
I know. I am also surprised.
Are you surprised for you too?
Yeah.
What is the turning point for you? I want to know. I don't know about other people.
Everyone wants to know. The nation wants to know.
I think I used to surround myself with everything. Like, iska attention, uska attention and everything. And I used to take and I used to do time pass. I used to binge eat. Basically. And I remember one day, you know, the boys have grown up. The elder one's now 19.
Yeah, right.
Gabriel's 16. Mm-hmm. And I don't know. I think I was getting a lot of, not even health complications, but, you know, like Remo knows, I mean, whoever knows that I have a lot of habit of shopping.
That's
how
even I know about it.
Yeah, so I can shop anywhere. Yeah. So the thing is that I started realizing that, you know, there was like a limited clothes that I was wearing. And I was basically living in my tracks, you know. And I don't know. I just think one day, you know, actually 2018 was not a good year for me because my mom passed away. In October, I was a bit low on I think self-esteem, and you know, because I think my mom was my very big support. And I'm a very confident person in general over the years, but I think in the last few years now I had lost my confidence. And I remember I got into an argument with Remo, and I'd become very cranky. I'd basically become a very cranky person, you know, arguing and fighting. And I don't know whether it was something about myself or I don't know. And one day Remo came to me and he said that, you know, listen, he came and he knew I was just depressed with my mom and I was just picking up fights. Praveen knows I do. I have that habit of picking up fights.
That's true. Who knows better than me and Remo said.
Yeah. Suddenly in the gym, working out, I can change. My mood can change. So he came and he hugged me and he said, you know what? This time you have to lose weight and we'll see to it that you lose weight. So you really want me to lose weight? He's like, yeah. I said, okay. Then I was sitting and I think I saw Praveen's post and then I messaged Praveen. So I told him, are you up for the challenge? And he said, yeah, let's meet tomorrow. And I think it just started off. And then Street Dancer happened. And I think with the flow, I knew that the film was releasing. And I had a responsibility of being a producer on the film. Mm-hmm. And I knew that maybe towards the end, I will have to come on things. I had to take care of myself. I couldn't be, you know, Dilli Dala types. We were stuck at 73 because we started weight training and stuff like that and all. Oh. And yes, lockdown, my diet was little changed because, not kept the, we had kept the intermittent fasting, but I think Praveen had put me on a 1200 calorie diet.
Correct.
Right?
Yes.
So I had thought that after just when the lockdown was opening, I said, nahi yaar, I have to give it a push, and then I went back on keto.
Correct.
You know, and I think it's just that now for me, every morning, the scale is something very, you know, I message you, arre yaar, mera water retention ho gaya, arre yaar, mera ye ho gaya.
I think 2 days ago you messaged me.
Yeah.
2-3 days mele message kiya tha.
Yeah, sometimes my weight just drops, then suddenly I think it's salt. I think, Mehak, you'll be able to actually say why is this, you know, being very appropriate on the diet, why is your body fluctuating? I don't know whether it's hormones or it is salt or it is less of water, which I do. I have a habit of keeping very less water. So I don't know. So that gets
three things. So all these three things clear a lot of difference. Like you said, one is your water intake. So the more water you drink, the better toxins you can release from your body. Second, also your sleep. So if your sleep pattern is irregular, like if you're not sleeping at a stretch for about like roughly around 7 to 8 hours, your hormonal level does get imbalanced. Because of that, okay, again, you will see that probably your weight would fluctuate the other day morning. When you wake up, okay, every day your weight would fluctuate. Like some, yeah, days if you have had a great sleep and your whole day, like you've eaten food with good amount of fiber and your stomach is not bloated, you do not have any gas issue or anything, then the next day your weight is going to be like low. It's going to be really nice. But probably some food which trigger you and do not suit your gut or probably is not good that time, is not doing well, the other day you will feel a lot more bloated and you would have water retention as well.
Okay. So tell me one thing, according to, I think Mehak, you have been, you know, very this thing on food and very thing. Tell me one thing, what according to you is the best diet that a person should follow and a healthy diet?
A healthy diet according to me, see, it all depends on what is your goal. So I believe that somebody who is looking for a weight loss, for them a ketogenic diet with the intermittent fasting is good when they're looking for a weight loss. But once they have achieved their goal, then I advise that you go in for a cyclic keto diet, wherein you start putting on some amount of carbohydrates so that you can start gaining quality of lean muscle mass. That's what, okay, we believe in. So we, okay, keep intermittent fasting, but then we don't do fasting for a long period of time. Okay. Then the fasting duration becomes smaller.
Now I want to ask you that you're motivating a lot of people around the world, but what's the impact on your kids? You know, I think I believe in a lot of kids' fitness, and you know, I believe that in their house you build that atmosphere, and the kids get really motivated by that. And of course, I know both of them very well, but you know, yeah, your second child is into fitness. I'm like, he's just boxing. And
Gabriel from childhood is a very self-independent child, you know. And he's always ahead in sports. I think he's taken off on the father. So, and he has his routine set.
Yeah.
So, even in the lockdown, like, first he used to go to Bandra for workouts and all. Now, he's doing online. And, you know, almost twice a week, you know, he is very serious about his workout. He comes, he works out, he like, I keep telling Remo, yaar, isko dekho, mujhe iske jaise karna hai workout. Because, you know, he does kickboxing and I don't know what all he does.
Yeah.
Touch wood. And I keep telling him now, I said, Gabriel, you know what? Trust me, your body's become better during lockdown. Then you bloody irritating me and going to the gym all the way. I think it's just, even he has realized, I think it's just a right eating and the right sleeping pattern.
Yeah.
Because, you know, first he used to roam. Now, his skin, his hair, everything is improved a lot because I think it's the sleeping pattern. In these 3 months, people had nothing but sleep, get up.
True, eat. That's true.
You know, everyone was even scared to order food from out. So,
yeah,
everyone was
eating
ghar ka khana. So, I think, you know, that was really making an effect on a lot of people. And I think even, you and Mehak were trying to even tell people that the same thing, that, you know, you can do it in your house. Hmm. You just need a mindset.
It was crazy food. I'm like, mere muh mein paani aa jata dekh ke. So I know that when you cook those food and feed them, what you must be going through. So what works behind that?
You know, honestly,
mere muh mein paani aa gaya abhi.
Paani to aa gaya. For me, like, I'll tell you one thing, I have gone to 104. So when I have reached that means I have eaten everything under the sun.
That's right, that's true.
So it's just that I feel ki maine kha liya hai na, aisa nahi that it is something different. See, like even Praveen knows, Mehak knows that for me, cheat days are not burgers, pizza,
yeah,
it's not that. I like to have pani puri,
yeah,
dal chawal papad.
That
is my, you know, thing.
Correct. Indian street food, I would rather say.
Yeah, yeah. So, and yeah, raste ka Chinese.
Ah.
So, you know, I like all that. Very chatpata.
Yeah.
So right now, so when my when my friends come over, I see like whatever I feel like eating, I order and I make everyone eat.
But you don't eat.
And they all abuse me. Yeah.
I know you don't eat.
And they all abuse. Like Remo is also behind me. That soon, मुझे ना अभी carbs बंद करना है. But every day I get up, I make for him something and I give him. He has no option but he has to eat. So he keeps looking at me and he's like, "Arey yar." So I think it's just that you know, I think people who have a habit of cooking know that you know when you cook, you get tired. You don't feel like eating. You don't, you know, you don't feel like you say, "Arey yar." मतलब हाँ वो थक जाता है इंसान खाना में. At least with me it is that. I have lost I think between 7 to 8 kilos on keto. But yeah, a point has come. I think right now, you know what? The even y'all have been making a lot of keto recipes and sharing it online. Honestly, the food if you make is so tasty. You don't honestly feel the need to. Yeah, you don't feel like binge eating. See, you know, Mehak, there is keto desserts. There is keto ice cream come out. There is...
and
keto...
when you have so many options available in ketogenic diet and when you know that you're eating everything guilt-free. See, at the end of the day, whatever you're making requires anything which has to be tasty has to have oil or butter. And the plus point in ketogenic diet is that you put oil or butter or ghee, that's what you use. So even if you're eating a smaller quantity, you have a lot of satiety. You don't feel like, oh my God, I want to eat a pizza because you can eat everything in keto. You can eat a broccoli crust pizza or anything. Everything is possible.
Okay, see, to suggest veg keto. So what are the options in veg keto?
So when you're doing veg, you can go in for good fats. You can use avocado. You can use Greek yogurt. So you can make like amazing ice creams, amazing smoothies with that. You can use fresh or frozen blueberries, but which are without sugar. Then you can use raspberries. All these will add really good amount of taste. Then you can bake healthy cheesecakes. So again, for being a vegetarian, you can also do that. You can have palak paneer. You can have all greens available under the earth. All the greens are allowed in keto. And you can use moderate amount of clarified butter. That's ghee, desi ghee. And you can make all the stuff into that. And you can use tofu, you can use paneer being a vegetarian. So you can use cauliflower fried rice. All of that can be done. These are great options when you're following a ketogenic diet.
Here in India, I think people have that wrong idea of keto.
Right,
okay,
very true.
So I want you to clear that misunderstanding of keto because I know a lot of people who have made keto a lifestyle.
Yeah.
So here people don't understand. It's, you know, they say one is an educated keto, one is an uneducated keto.
Very true.
Here we tend to follow an uneducated keto. And then people think ki nahi yaar main to keto kar hi raha hu, main to itna cheese to kha hi raha hu. मैं तो इतना तो खा ही रहा हूँ अभी इसमें मैं तो रोटी नहीं खा रहा हूँ ना राइस खा रहा हूँ तो व्हाई एम आई नॉट लूजिंग वेट बट पीपल हैव टू यू नो पीपल नीड टू रियलाइज दैट इवन अनियंस इवन कॉलीफ्लावर एवरी वेजिटेबल हैज कीटो हैज सॉरी कार्ब सो महक व्हाट इज द राइट प्रोपोर्शन
दैट द पर्सन हैज टू फॉलो. When you talk about right proportion, it all depends on the basic metabolic, that is the BMI of the person. It has to be calculated and to be taken under a guidance of a nutritionist or probably consulting somebody, I believe. Like people watch a lot of online videos because right now on Instagram, you see, you find n number of people uploading a lot of things.
Like you said,
so there are a lot of misconceptions wherein people use a lot of tomato, onion. All these things will put you out of ketosis, even if you take little higher amount because all of these contain carb. So all of these have to be completely stopped. Plus, apart from that, you have to do your keto tiran. So that you know that what stage of ketosis you are you falling into ketosis because people tend to really eat a lot of stuff, like you said, they eat a lot of cashews in keto, which is again wrong. You don't have to eat a lot of cashews, you can't eat a lot of peanuts. So everything has to be in an adequate quantity. That's how it goes.
I'll pick up from you a bit. I'll just speak about the keto notes and like develop YouTube. 450 videos, which includes of the workout and the diet, all the information that is provided. So pretty much everything is there. When you speak about Indian keto, what happens is that people eat butter chicken and they say, I'm in keto.
Yeah.
So now butter chicken has, of course, butter chicken, but at the same time, it has a lot of tomato which goes into it, or probably onion which goes into it. So this provides fructose. So when you have enough of glycogen, which is filled in the liver and the muscles, the body is going to store the fat which you already have consumed. Before we speak much in detail about ketosis or anything about fat reduction or using fat as a source of energy, the first and the most important thing what you need to understand is that what is ketosis? That's a stage where the body is using the fat, stored fat, into the system as fuel. So that can be only happening when you deplete your glycogen levels. So that's very important that you understand these calculations behind it. So when you talk about any vegetables, 99% of vegetables has carbohydrates or probably has fructose.
Someone has asked that can teenagers 16 and above follow keto?
I would say that if an athlete, you don't want to consider keto as a thing, but if you're someone layman, like, I would say a person who goes to the gym, again, they become very normal. They're not exceptional. But an athlete who trains probably more than 4 or 5 hours, you need to consume carbohydrates. You need to have, there are some source of carbohydrates that you need to have in your body. But if you're someone at 16, and if you look at like places like Bombay or Maharashtra, by the age of 16, most of the people do turn into fat, you know. And that's the reason of actually our eating habits. So for them, it's going to be great because I have a gym which is exactly opposite of your school. I get to see, should not take name, but I get to see these kids going out of the school at about, was about probably seven, in the 7th or 8th standard. 99% of the kids are into that stage of fat or probably they have turned into fat. So if they get to understand how does the ketosis work, or even up to an extent, how does the intermittent fasting work, they can be in a great shape because every individual want to look good, you know, when they look in the mirror. So it's very simple that this is a great thing until and unless if you're not an athlete.
And someone is asking here that for PCOD.
PCOD, yeah.
So is what keto safe for PCOD? No, someone else is asking here that is keto safe for PCOD and thyroid?
See, let me come down to this one. See, if you're taking any thyroid medications, which means that you're already in complete control of the thyroid, first thing. Second thing, PCOD again is a situation that your hormones are all the way, all over the place. And so that's another case. Okay, let's keep these two things different.
See, I'll tell you one thing. I'm also a PCOD. I also have PCOD, okay? Because PCOD, I think, is a lot to do with weight also.
Exactly. I'm just
if you go, if you go to your doctor and your gynec, he'll tell you only one thing: lose weight.
First thing,
your PCOD will go.
Yeah,
I'm going to come back to this. Aradhya Nair. Aradhya also paid us.
Yeah.
There was
yeah.
So now in this situation is that, like, let me take an example of a man who gains or probably who becomes overweight. They produce something or less. They develop something or less gynecomastia. That's a
Yeah.
A male produces more estrogen. Similar manner, when a woman goes overweight, the estrogen levels completely goes all over the place. And the first thing, if you're considering that you are having a medical condition, is to do with the weight. Then the first thing about is about losing weight. And keto is a great option, but the right methods. But you know what? What I generally get to see that people consume a lot of fat, as Lizelle said a few minutes back, but you know, I'm taking a lot of cheese, so I'm in ketosis. That's not a solution. Until unless you don't take the right proportion of carbohydrates, fats, and even in this first few months, if you're consuming a lot of protein, the protein can eventually break down with energy. So you want to make sure that even the protein intake is also limited.
Yeah.
And I would say a lot of fiber is a great option. At the same time, including the fiber, add up the portion of the fats. Coming down to the question of the thyroid and the PCOD or the PCOS, It's a great option if at all anybody's looking for to lose weight or be in a great shape. Not only from, see, weight loss is different thing. That's what the major population of the people are facing the problem. And we always end up talking about it. So I'm 38 now. And I look pretty much the same way from last, I would say, 18, 19 years now. And I have been more or less following a very low-carb diet or a complete keto diet. And I think I've been successful enough to maintain.
Yeah, when Praveen comes to the gym, 5 minutes he spends looking at himself, looking at his legs, flexing.
I know,
10 minutes I take for my selfies and then we start workout.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, Praveen Bizyal has become thin and like very good looking and very hot, I would say. Lizard spends a lot of time in the mirror or the camera.
I swear he keeps shouting at me like so much in the gym when I tell him, dude, look at everyone thinks I'm the only hard working person.
You all both compliment, na? Even he has that habit. Even he keeps looking in the mirror.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know what, Lizard?
And I honestly.
You remember me?
So Praveen has a habit, whoever knows, like Puneet knows, whoever Salman knows, Remo knows, whoever
Raghav,
everyone knows that Praveen has a habit of pinching you when you're not working out. Or Praveen has a habit of shooting. And, you know, even like a lot of people have told me, even on keto, like keto exactly, Mehak, what is the breakup? It's how much percent fat, how much percent protein, and how much percent carbs.
So again, it depends from person to person. So when we talk about somebody who's very overweight, we ideally ask them that they go in for at least 70% of fat. Then the remaining 20% would be your protein and 10% would be your carbohydrate.
Okay. Currently, cabbage, like cauliflower. Even cauliflower, I think 100 grams of cauliflower has 10 grams of carbs, if I'm not mistaken.
Yeah. If you're overdoing anything, like when you take a moderate quantity, like when we say if you take about 5 to 10 almonds, depending on the person's weight, whatever the person's weight is when you remove, for them, I think more than 10, anything would be like more than 10 almonds would be an overdo. So,
like for me, I'll tell you one thing, now that I am on this, like, I have been told that I can consume half an onion because it has carbs. I can consume maximum if I want to go. Maximum if I want to go into is one big tomato or one and a half tomato. Okay.
Right.
Cauliflower, like the other day, you know, one thing, I always used to hate cauliflower. Cauliflower is my worst sabji. Okay. That day, I said, listen, I have to make cauliflower biryani. And honestly, I made the cauliflower biryani and, you know, that day I felt ki yaar, I mean, I ate it, okay, I didn't feel the difference. Yes, rice is just a little more grainy, but I only made it, the biryani, and I ate. Trust me, I didn't feel the difference. And I was telling Remo ki yaar, you know, there are now so many good places. There are so many, like y'all put so many recipes. There are so many things that you can do on keto. So like what I do now is I, like once a week, like I made a thing that Sunday, chalo milna hai, we are meeting up with friends and all. So Sunday is one day where I said, chalo, I'll have an almond bread. Like you said, people think ki almond bread khalo.
Right.
But you can, like Sunday, I have kept it for me like a keto cheat meal.
Yeah.
You all know I can't do without Diet Coke. So my Diet Coke is one Diet Coke on Sunday. Yeah. And I see that I make almond flour ka one roti. Or I make almond flour ka garlic bread. Or something, you know. How perfect is the urine test? Because I thought that's the only.
That's a good point. You picked up before I say it.
Yeah.
Urine test doesn't show exactly the content that we want to track it down on the keto. But of course, the blood prick test is an accurate way of doing it. But I believe we don't get that machine over here. We got it from US. The keto urine test strips are available easily. And it's very kind of easy way to do it. In the morning, you wake up, you put some drops, you get to see it. But that's not the actual keto. But being said that, for someone who's starting and don't have the machine, that's still okay. until unless you're not in curiosity, that person will not show whether you are in that stage or not. So
tell me one thing, how accurate is this trip to show you are in ketosis? Does it show you exactly,
it's
like if it is dark maroon, if it is thing, is it right or is it still?
When it shows like extremely dark, like you're at a very high level of ketosis on this trip, but when you do the blood prick test, you will come to know that you're probably at the initial stage or the start stage of ketosis. So you can't relate to the urine.
You
and
can't
the blood.
Relate.
Blood is
100%
more accurate. Yeah.
This way.
Tell me one thing: is with the keto, what is the thing with the taste? The keto breath. A lot of people face is the keto breath.
Keto breath is something very common. I would say. You want to make sure that you use some mouth fresheners at that time in the initial phase. I would say.
Yeah.
But again, much in the ketosis that. That happens to people who are generally used to the system of carbohydrates. When you're switching on, I would say initial one or first or second month, you may face it. But again, the one few thing that you can do that, drink a lot of water and using some Listerine, it could be good options. Or I've seen a lot of people using even lychee to be one of the good options to be. But again, someone who's following an intermittent fasting, I would say a great option would be that keep drinking water.
Keep drinking water.
Keto breath is very common, but it's very common. Keto breath, keto fever, I would say.
So I think, Praveen, it was amazing talking to you. And
thank you, Lizzie.
I can't wait to start workout again.
A few things that I noticed as a coach is that you're looking amazing.
Thank you.
Can see a jawline, which is, I should take some pictures of yours right now. Looking amazing. I'm so happy to see you.
Thank you.
And keep it up, man. You've been an inspiration, not only for those people, in fact, for me,
for all of us.
Thank you. Praveen, but 6 more kilos to go. Then only I'll tell you you're out of your black daughter. Otherwise, you're still, I'm still your black daughter.
More than for me, I think you should, now not the 6 packs, I would say. You want to be in a situation that you come in a sports brand saying that you look at my 6 packs.
Yeah. Exactly. Yeah. Very soon.
I think that should be some cool goal, isn't it?
Yeah.
But I think gyms should open, and then Praveen and I need 3 months together. Bus.
Let's get there. I'm really excited to see 6 packs. And I'm sure Praveen must have got a swimsuit also.
Lots of love. See you soon.
Thank you so much.
Bye.
Bye.